Candace Owens is the host of Candace. She joins us tonight. Candace, thanks so much for coming on. Maybe I'm being too soft, but anybody who can talk, you know, America's woke corporate structure into sending close to $100 million on the basis of that lame rap kind of gets my respect in a way.
She has my respect because she's unapologetic in her approach. She's telling you what she is. She's a Marxist. So Marxists steal money from other people and they enrich themselves right. until the people that they stole from are poor. And so she has stolen money from other people on the pretext of a lie that is Black Lives Matter. And she's enriched herself yeah. and she's brought four homes. I mean, you have to kind of appreciate the honesty. She's not hiding by any means, you know. And so, yeah, I tend to agree with you here. She's a communist through and through, and she's been unbelievably unapologetic in her approach.
Al Sharpton must be looking at this and saying, like, I've done this for 40 years. Where did I go wrong? I don't have a house in Topanga Canyon.
Right, exactly
I really
right. It's completely ridiculous. And, you know, you're right. The corporations are standing behind her, which is incredibly interesting. And you pointed to something really important. You know, these corporations that are pouring millions and millions of dollars into Black Lives Matter, and you're correct, they said, we raised more than $90 million. How much more, we will never know. But $90 million, of which $21 million apparently went to, according to Black Lives Matter themselves, it went to building the black movement. Like, I don't even know what that means. $25 million going to building a black movement. Apparently, the black movement was Patrice moving herself, a black woman moving herself into other areas of the communities of people that she claims are oppressing black Americans. She's fearful of white people. White people are so bad. Well, why doesn't she want to live amongst black people? Why is she choosing to move herself into an all-white neighborhood? These are important questions.
Yeah, I think they are. It's Topanga Canyon, not Riverside County. Really quickly, the looting that we're seeing in Minneapolis was just reflexive. This police shooting does sound like it raises questions about the competence of the police officer and what's going on with the Minneapolis Police Department. Maybe they've lowered the standards. Maybe there aren't, you know, enough cops. Who knows? We should find out, I think. But looting in immediate response to that, why would we put up with that?
We shouldn't put up with that, but the reason why we do is because the Democrats see some advantage in this, right? So right now you have a bunch of criminals that love Black Lives Matter as an organization. They love when a black person dies, and we don't know what the reasons are. We don't know what happened, but it signals to them that they are now allowed to run into the streets and grab whatever they want, whether it's from Target, whether it's from Walmart. And what's remarkable also is that these corporations are standing behind Black Lives Matter, right? They're pouring money into these corporations, and I remember most notably during the George Floyd riots, Target even came out and said, we don't even care that we were rioted and looted because we just stand with Black Lives Matter. That's not a normal thing for a corporation to do when it's losing money. So that means that a corporation must be getting something else, right? What is it? What are they investing in when they invest in the lie that is Black Lives Matter? What is the return? I think Josh Hawley alluded to it in the previous segment, and I think you're onto something when you say that the corporations seek to control this country. They're willing to give up money. They're willing to let their stores be rioted and looted because they see something bigger that they're gaining from these riots and these lootings and these lies, and that is control over this country. It's power, and it's sinister, and it's sick.
And if some Pakistani liquor store owner is destroyed in the process, like, you think Jeff Bezos cares? No. Candace Owens, so nicely put, as always. It's great to see you. Thank you.
Thank you.